In the fall of 1915, during MIT's final year in Boston, a brash 25-year-old graduate student, Vannevar Bush, already the inventor of a new surveyor's tool, arrived on campus declaring he would earn his doctorate in electrical engineering in a single year. By the time the brand new Cambridge campus held its dedication ceremony 9 months later, Bush had his PhD in hand. It was the start of an astonishing career, perhaps unmatched for its influence on the growth of American science and technology in the 20th century. Bush would play a part in the rise of radio, the building of the atomic bomb, the founding of the National Science Foundation, and even the dawn of the digital age. It's earlier than you think, he'd like to say, encouraging his colleagues to stay positive and think big. Bush got his take charge attitude, he said, from the line of sea captains in his family. They have a way of running things without any doubt, he said. That left me with some inclination to run a show once I was in it. Bush began teaching at MIT in 1919, but he kept up his inventions and entrepreneurial efforts at full force. The S-tube, not invented but refined by Bush, came to market in 1924. It turned the tricky new technology of home radio into a simple plug-in device at the exact moment that national radio broadcasting was taking off. The company Bush set up to sell the S-tube grew over time to become the major American defense contractor, Raytheon. In the 1930s, Bush developed the room-filling differential analyzer, a mechanical computer that Bush said represented an ideal, the ability to think straight in the midst of complexity. During the Second World War, the Defense Department would have it running 24 hours a day. By 1939, Bush had become MIT's vice president, dean of engineering, and a lifetime member of the MIT board. But he left to become president of the Carnegie Institute in Washington, D.C. During World War II, Bush was President Franklin D. Roosevelt's top science advisor. He also managed all American defense contracts and initiated and managed the secret project to build the atomic bomb. Never publicity shy, Bush later reenacted a crucial 1941 meeting for a newsreel.
The Germans are certainly working on an atomic bomb.
What was your impression of British progress?
The war made Bush a national figure. Asked by President Roosevelt for post-war plans, Bush proposed the creation of a standing national research group, what soon became the National Science Foundation. In 1945, Bush laid out an early vision of the information age in a popular magazine article. He imagined a microfilm machine called Memex, a searchable memory supplement to help cope with the post-war explosion of information. Bush had anticipated the modern internet search engine by 50 years. By 1963, Bush could clearly see the coming power of the digital age.
The analytical machine, which will supplement a man's thinking methods, which will think for him, will have as great an effect in that way as the invention of the machine way back took the load off of men by giving them mechanical power instead of the power of their muscles.
Bush returned to MIT as chairman of the corporation in 1957 and remained a popular public figure in American science until his death in 1974. Building 13 was named the Bush Building in his honor, and Bush's spirit lives on at the school, where students and faculty continue to push for innovation, invention, and practical solutions to the world's problems.